In this lesson, we delve into business impact analysis as part of business continuity planning. This is part of Domain 1 of the CISSP CBK. Business Impact Analysis, or BIA, focuses on critical business functions, or CBFs. Understanding and measuring business impact helps an organization prioritize what continuity challenges to address first. It also enables IT to work with management and the recovery team to ensure recovery of business functions within a time frame acceptable to function owners. A BIA must address different types of impact. The type of impact depends on the type of event. Business impact focuses on human welfare and cost to the business. Examples include loss of one or more business functions, lost revenue due to loss of customer confidence, settlements to civil litigation, fines and other statutory or regulatory sanctions, and loss of capitalization because of loss of investor confidence. The BIA process consists of two steps. First, the business continuity team works with management to identify CBFs. Second, the team continues to work with management to determine measures of impact and acceptable and achievable recovery milestones. A critical business function is required for continued business operation. This includes both customer-facing functions and internal functions like payroll. In some industries, some functions are necessary for regulatory compliance. Continuance of patient care falls into this category, and it involves addressing human welfare. Business continuity measures of impact are closely tied to how much interruption to a business-critical function is acceptable. They include maximum tolerable downtime, recovery point objective, recovery time objective, and work recovery time. The recovery team must work with function owners to determine reasonable and appropriate associated numbers. Maximum tolerable downtime is the maximum amount of time a business function can be down before the organization experiences substantial losses from which it might not be able to fully recover. The recovery point objective, or RPO, is the point to which an organization can be restored. It depends on how backups are done and how behind backups are from actual business functions. In other words, how much data is lost even after restoring a backup. The recovery time objective is the length of time needed or expected to achieve the recovery point objective. It represents the minimum operational capability expected by the function owner. The RTO must be less than the MTD. The work recovery time is how long it takes the business to re-enter information or transactions that were lost due to the age of the restored backup. It is the time from the minimum operational capability restored at the RTO to full functional operability. At the end of the work recovery time, the business functions are fully restored. Now let's quickly walk through how the measures work. First, the system and the supported business functions are working properly during the mean time before failure. Mean time before or between failures is an expectation of how long a function will operate before it fails. Eventually, the system does fail, taking down supported business functions. IT, or the incident response team, responds and returns the system and data to the recovery point objective during the recovery time objective. Finally, relevant teams re-enter transactions not included in the restored backup. Note that recovery of a system and restoration of backups does not usually provide full business functionality. The combined time represented by the RTO and the WRT should fall within the maximum tolerable downtime. It is also important to note that manual processes identified during business continuity planning can restore full but inefficient function operation before the end of the WRT is reached. Business impact analysis for business continuity is not just for failures or disasters. It also applies to any interruption to business functions, including those caused by attacks or attack response. For example, a ransomware attack can take down some or all critical business functions. Containment activities during a response to any attack can temporarily make one or more functions unavailable. Consequently, business continuity and incident response teams must work together to plan for and recover from CBF failures. This is a worksheet you can use to conduct a qualitative BIA. Working with affected managers, the team identifies business functions, determines criticality, and calculates an expected MTD for each function. The team enters the RTO and WRT required with current recovery capabilities. The sum of these two measures is automatically calculated as the MTD that recovery teams can currently meet. The team compares this to the expected MTD. If the calculated MTD exceeds the expected MTD, there's work to be done. You can download this worksheet from adventuresinsecurity.com/tools/BIA_worksheet.xlsx. That's it for this lesson. If you have questions, please ask. And until next time, be careful what you click.